press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students. So let me introduce myself first. Myself, Chandrasekhar, namely CS sir, senior faculty in physics, Siddhaganga PU College, Davangere. So I am here to have some sessions. As you know, we are in continuation with the topics of first year physics. As we have already completed with basic mathematic tools, what are all it is necessary for physics, so we have already done with, and then basic units which it is required in order to measure any physical quantities, the dimensions, so we have done with that. So now the next chapter what we are having in the continuation of that from the first part of NCERT text what we are having is motion in a straight line. So we are going to have the discussion on that chapter today. We'll start with that. Motion in a straight line. So this is not any new chapter for you, as you have come up in your schooling, very basic things. So like when a body is said to be in motion, what exactly the motion is? So what do you mean by rest? So different types of motions we have to discuss with. In continuation of this, we are having one more chapter in continuation of this, that is motion in a plane. So one is motion in a straight line, the next one is motion in a plane. So what exactly we are going to discuss about, I'll just briefly outline of these topics first. So then we'll move on into those chapters or into the topics of the chapter very in depth. So before going for all into the chapter, so what are all you have studied in your schooling, in your lower classes? So I just want you to recall those things which you have already dealt with. So very basic terminology like, what do you mean by position of the particle? What do you mean by a body said to be at rest? What do you mean by a body said to be in motion? Right? Along with that, some more properties or some more parameters you have studied with, like path length, distance, displacement, speed, velocity, acceleration. So what exactly those parameters are? So we have to recall with, you know, you have already studied with. In continuation of that, in depth about that, we need to dig into the topics. What are all you have studied for your schooling, right? In continuation for that, right? This is small continuity for that what you have already studied with. So we need to look for those. And then there is some specialty in these two topics what we are learning, motion in straight line and motion in plane. So there is some common properties associated with these types of motion. See, in physics, you know, particularly this part of physics what we are studying, almost your entire NCERT part text 1 is mechanics, which to say. See, this total physics, we are having different branches. So like mechanics, in this mechanics we are going to study about it has been segregated again like kinematics and dynamics. So what exactly this kinematics? This part will fall into the kinematics. So what exactly the kinematics, I'll let you know. And further continuation of that kinematics, we are going to dynamics, that is loss of motion, work energy, power and so on. Those topics will come under dynamics. What exactly this kinematics or dynamics we will study. And apart from that, on the other part of the NCERT text, we are going to have the discussion like heat. So it's a form of energy, right? So how it can be converted from one form to other form, and all the effects or influence of heat, what it is, we are going to study from the other part of the text. So this is all your first year part, what mechanics majorly, you'll study with the mechanics and as well as heat. And when it comes to the second year part, you know, it's like different branches over there, like electromagnetism we are going to study, and then optics is one more, and then modern physics, that is physics, classical physics is one where before 19th century what are all the changes that have been take place. So that means before the discovery of electron, the terms what are all we are very rarely calling, like electron, proton, neutron, nucleus, so all those, right? So before that era, before the introduction of that era, whatever the physics we have studied is classical physics, and almost it is after 19th century and before 19th century, we used to say. Before 19th century, so whatever the physics we used to call, right, whatever the physics we have studied is classical physics. And after 19th century, after this, like after the discovery of this electron and so on, so what are all the later changes that have been taken place after this 19th century, beginning of the 19th century, right? So that physics we used to call it as modern physics. So that part of the text, modern physics, all this electromagnetism, everything will come within this, after this 19th century itself. So that part of the text we are going to study in the second year of your PU. So likewise, different branches of physics where we are studying with. So firstly, about mechanics we have to study. Mechanics. In this course of mechanics, when you are studying, I told you, firstly as kinematics, majorly we have to study as what? Kinematics. And then the other one is dynamics. Kinematics and dynamics. So even in this Newtonian mechanics we are having, where all the Newton's laws to be considered while we are going to have the discussion related to the concepts, so that we have to come across. So as of our discussion, with we'll have the discussion firstly about what do you mean by kinematics and what exactly the dynamics is. What exactly the dynamics? So kinematics, it's a branch of physics which deals with all the bodies which are moving with uniform acceleration. Uniform acceleration. If the bodies are moving with uniform acceleration, motion under uniform acceleration, motion under uniform acceleration, all the motion of the bodies which are studying, which are moving under uniform acceleration, right? So such a type of motion we are going to study under the heading of what? Kinematics. That's what. See, in this kinematics, you know, here in our discussion, we will be studying under the heading of, first is motion in a straight line. Motion in a straight line. Motion in a straight line. And the other one is motion in a plane. I'll just come back what exactly straight line and plane, what exactly they are. So what the chapter is all about, I'll just have a discussion about that. Firstly, under the heading of kinematics, what is kinematics? I told, a body which is moving under uniform acceleration, right? And we are not bothered about the cause of the motion, not considering the cause of the motion, not considering cause of the motion, cause of the motion. So what are all we are going to study will be under kinematics. What exactly the cause for the motion, we are not bothered about. Cause for the motion means what? Let me say, if a body is at rest, simply if you say it to move, it will move. No, it won't move, right? Some cause for that, there should be some cause for its motion. If I'm going to make a body to drop, or if I'm going to leave this, I'm going to hold at this point. If I'm going to leave here, what happens? Obviously, it falls under gravity. So there is some cause for it. What's the cause over here? Gravitational pull or gravitational force. The gravitational force is trying to pull it downward. That is the cause. Right? So we are not bothered about the cause of the motion when you talk about the kinematics. Whereas, we'll be discussing about the cause of the motion, what exactly it is. Our accelerated bodies will be studied under the heading of dynamics. This is the other part of physics. In the same mechanics we have to study, in your NCERT part 1 of the text itself, we are going to have the discussion about this also. So, namely under the heading of loss of motion, the coming chapters what I am talking about. Loss of motion. See, a brief view of the topic we are discussing, chapter we are having. If you are having some hold on the topics what you are going to discuss with, it will be easier for you or convenient for you to move on into the topic. So I haven't entered into this chapter still. I am just briefing out what exactly this, what we are going to have the discussion. So loss of motion as well as work energy power. So even that, all this, they are all for the cause. By considering the cause of the motion, cause is about force. So effects of force, its influence on the motion of the body, how it is, they are all called accelerated bodies, right? So it's not like the body need to move with uniform acceleration when you are studying about what? Dynamics. Okay, so this is another part what we have to study in the later part of our course of discussion. We're going to have the discussion related to the dynamics. Nothing to bother, you just have an idea. So what exactly this entire mechanics what you are going to study with. So in this course of discussion, so now we are in kinematics where we have to study. So I told you we are not bothered about the cause of the motion, how much force are applied, we are not bothered. Okay, so if a body is moving, we are interested in studying about its under its uniform acceleration. So certain parameters, like I told you already, position of the particle, what exactly it is, right? So what exactly the position of the particle is, how much is the distance it has traveled, right? So majorly we have to study with what exactly the position of the particle, its a distance, right, a displacement related to that, you know, like a speed, velocity, acceleration. So many terms we are going to study: speed, velocity, acceleration. In continuation of that, you know, we are going to have some more points we are going to introduce. This kinematics, you know, all about study about these particular points out there, and that too for a body which is moving with uniform acceleration. This is a very, very important thing you have to remember. What are all you are studying for a body moving under uniform acceleration, right, without considering the cause of the motion, which to call it as what? That part of the physics we'll study under what? Heading of kinematics. I'm recalling this point again and again. So reason is, the equations what we are going to learn from this chapter cannot be used wherever you want. We'll see as we move in depth into the topics, you know, then you'll come to know. So what is the importance of this this term for a body moving with uniform acceleration? So why only we need to consider those equations in these conditions? So for that purpose only, repeatedly I am telling you that only under the body moving with uniform accelerations, what are all the equations we'll study under the heading of kinematics should be made used. So we'll go in depth all those points one by one we'll study. So that is a very basics are related to the chapter what you have to learn with. So now I'll just move on to what is this motion in a straight line we are talking about. And in continuation to that, what exactly the motion in a plane is, right? So I'll just have a small brief introduction about that, so that we'll go into the topics one by one. So now, I told you a body moving with uniform acceleration. So what exactly it is, uniform acceleration? Right, so that too in a straight line I told you, in a plane I told you. So what exactly it is? Now I need to speak something about rest. So what do you mean by rest? Or before going for the actual definitions and everything, so let me say, a body is moving in a straight line, we'll say, means what? A path traveled by the particle from one point to other point will be in a straight line path, and that too in one direction itself. What do you mean by this one direction? Generally, we are having some coordinate system what you have learnt with: x axis, y axis, and this is z axis. I hope you are all familiar with this. This is the x direction. Towards the right of me, I am taking it as the x direction, and upward is going to be taken as the y direction, and just out of the board I am going to take it as z direction. Okay, x, y, and z directions. We can't represent it outward the line, right? So that's why I represented over in this direction. That is z in the sense what? It is outward. So like this, three coordinates I have taken: x, y, and z. So now, if a body is moving in a straight line, if I say, means the body's motion will be constrained only to one direction. That means it moves only along x direction, or only along y direction, or only along z direction. Got the point? Straight line motion means the motion of the body is rectilinear also, we can say straight line motion, or we can also call it as rectilinear motion. So what exactly the rectilinear motion is? If a body is going to constant to move only in one direction, or in a straight line path, or in along the straight line, if the body is moving, then that motion is said to be what? Rectilinear motion or translatory motion also. Straight line or translatory motion or rectilinear motion. These are different names, different terminology, how we can call this. Rectilinear motion or straight line motion. It just confined to move only in one direction. If it travels from origin, let me say an ant, I am going to take motion of an ant, where the ant is initially at origin. Okay, so now if I am going to speak something about ant is moving in straight line path, if I am going to say, meaning is it has started from origin and it moves only along x direction. After some time its position on x direction is some 2 meters, if I say it has travelled in the straight line path till 2 meters, it travelled in straight line path till 4 meters, till 5 meters and so on. And if I say, if it moves only along y direction, if I say, that means it has been moving vertically upward, that ant, now it is moving in which direction? Vertically upward direction. Even that is one type of straight line motion. Or if it moves out of the board, let me say, then that is one kind of, one type of straight line motion, you can say. Got it? So, straight line motion is motion in a straight line, in the sense, the body's motion is confined to one direction itself, one direction, that is straight line. So now talking about something about plane, so what exactly the plane is? Motion in a plane, if I talk something about, right, motion in a plane, if I am going to mention, so what exactly the motion in a plane? Straight line means no doubt it is moving only in one direction itself, either x, either y or either z. So now if it is about motion in a plane, if I want to speak of, now ant starts from here. See carefully all of you, and starts from here, right? It just moves away like this from one corner of the board to the other corner of the board. Let me say this is what our board is confined to. Started from origin, it has been moved from one corner to the other corner of the board. So now, of course, it is straight line, it traveled in the straight line direction, let it be, whatever it may be. Or else, you think of in random directions, it has been moved and finally it reached this point, let me say. Now the motion is not a straight line, right? Its initial position, you know, and final position. Has it travelled only in x direction? No. Has it travelled only in y direction? No. Means, meanwhile the ant has reached this point, you know, it has travelled this much amount of x distance and this much amount of y distance it has travelled. In the sense, it has its motion in both directions. What is that? In x direction as well as in y direction. So that means, this particular motion we used to call it as plane. Now this is plane. Plane, do consider, remember plane. Whenever I am speaking about plane in the terminology in the coming topics, wherever it is, right? How many points do I require to represent a point in plane? 2 points. At least 2 points it is required. So this is XY plane I will call. This is X axis and this is Y axis. And the plane which is confined to this one, we used to call it as what? XY plane. What do you call that as? XY plane this is. XY plane. So, in order to represent a point in xy plane, how many coordinates do I require? 2 coordinates. If I want to represent a point in a plane, how many coordinates do I require? 2 coordinates. What are those? How much x distance and how much y distance. So, that is about a representation of a point in a plane. So, now, when a body is moving like this, right, in this plane, then that is said to be under what? Motion in a plane. And remember, here also, the body will be moving with uniform acceleration, not with non-uniform acceleration. It will be moving with what? Uniform acceleration itself. Okay. So, this is what representation of a point in a plane. So, now if it is moving only in x direction, how many points are required in order to represent its position? Only one. One coordinate is enough in order to represent the position of the particle if it is moving in a straight line. If it is moving in straight line, you know, I will say if it is moving along x axis, then only x coordinate is enough to represent the position of the particle. If it is moving only in y direction, how many coordinates are required? Only one coordinate. Position of the particle is so and so, y equals to 2 meter I can say. After certain instant of time, position of the particle is y equals to 2 meter, 4 meter or something you can mention. One coordinate is enough to represent for a body position of the particle in straight line. At the same time, if the body is moving in plane, how many coordinates are required in order to represent the position? Two coordinates. This is xy plane, I told. So can you tell me which is this plane now? The plane where it is going to be. So I told you this is x axis and the outward is what? Z axis, right? So this plane we used to call it as what? Xz plane now. X axis is there and z axis we are having. That's why it is xz plane. Okay. And if I take this plane now. So if I take this plane for this board, I'll take this plane. So this part of this if I'm going to take. What are the two axes we are having in this plane? It is having y axis as well as it is having z axis even. Means what? This is yz plane it is. This will be what? Yz plane. Okay, so the floor what I am standing now is which plane? The floor where I am standing. It is having which all the coordinates it is having, tell me? It is having x axis and towards you it is having what? Z axis. So which plane it is? Xz plane once again, just similar to the like this. This is what? Xz plane. The floor which I am standing is xz. And this plane is what? XY plane. And this plane is what? Y and Z, YZ plane. So like that, you can take one of the corner of the room where you are staying and you can locate all the planes what you are having. The floor which you are standing is which plane, the top of that is which plane, right? Behind you which plane you are having, right? And what about this plane, beside you which type of plane, what do you call that plane as? And even to the other side of the room what plane it is, you can all represent, you will get some general view of that. See, in physics, not just the formulas to be remembered or not just definitions to be by hearted, a small sort of imagination it is required. Imagination is required if you want to you have to realize for a few things, you know, bit of imagination, like as I told you, right? So what exactly this plane, what do you mean by axis, what do you mean by plane, and so on. So apart from this, we are having even motion in three dimensions. Three dimension means, instead of ant, I will take a mosquito now, or a house fly, whatever it is. Initially, it is at the corner of your room, let me say. It is somewhere at the corner of your room, or you can take any of the corner. You can take it as origin. From that corner, it has been moved to this position, let me say, in front of you, it is flying. But the point, it's not just moving in straight line or in plane now. So now it has started somewhere from the corner, or else you take this for the corner, and from here it has come to this position, let me say. This position means, what do you mean by this? Now it has traveled some x distance, it has traveled some y distance, as well as it traveled some z distance. So that means, how many coordinates do this particle, this house fly do have at this particular position now? Three coordinates, x, y and z at z point. Right, x coordinate it is having, y coordinate and z coordinate. So three coordinates are required, or three points are required in order to represent position of the particle in three dimension. If you want to study about motion in three dimension, this motion is straight line and this motion is plane, where we will have two points to represent the position of the particle. If you want to talk something about motion in three dimension, motion in three dimension in the sense, I do require three position coordinates in order to represent x, y as well as z. Accordingly, it will be varying. If it has started from this position and has moved to this position, for example, means its x distance varied, y distance varied and z distance varied. So every time its position is going to be changing according to these three coordinates x, y and z. That is motion in three dimensions. See, in our first PU syllabus what we are having, under the heading of kinematics, our discussion is constrained only to straight line and plane. There is no much in-depth discussion on motion in three dimensions. So that is out of our text. So nothing to bother. So these two chapters we have to focus on. I hope you got small idea what exactly straight line motion and what do you mean by the plane exactly. Okay. So from here we'll move on to the actual topics, which has to be learnt with, starting with basic definitions, and then we'll move on to the learn all the required parameters, whichever it is required. So now, Okay. As we are talking about motion is straight line and uniformly accelerated bodies, keep it in mind. We will study what exactly the uniform accelerated bodies are before going for all. So let us start with a very basic terminology. So what do you mean by position? We have already studied. It is just representation of a point with respect to a reference frame. So what do you mean by a reference frame? Once again, reference frame means all the measurements of motion of a body or certain constant parameters of the body are represented with respect to certain reference frame means with respect to certain coordinate system, or with respect to what you are going to measure is reference system. With respect to what? I am going to represent all these with respect to this board, for example. Means taking this board as a reference, I just speak of motion of this body. And generally we will be taking the reference system or frame of reference as the coordinate system, XY coordinate system. So means with respect to this coordinate system, right, taking this as origin from where the body, if it starts from 2 meters, let's say, with respect to XY plane, right, the body is starting at x equals to 2 meters. That's what the mean. Body is starting at x equals to 2 meters, we can say. And if it traveled from one point, let me say A to B, right, some 1, 2 if it has traveled, or some 3, 2 if it has traveled, with respect to this coordinate system, or with respect to this frame of, what is the frame of reference I have taken here? This XY coordinate system, I have taken it as what? Frame of reference. Frame of reference is the system, reference system, or we can say with respect to what we are going to measure all the measurements. Measurements of what? Motion of this particular body. Any body when it is moving, all the motion parameters of that body are going to be measured with respect to certain frame. So that reference frame itself is what? Frame of reference. So that we have to remember with. Here I have taken generally most of all the discussions, right, will be taking. And if measurements are made with respect to earth, generally we'll, for us earth is at rest. Okay, so if you go to some other planet, you know, will the earth be at rest? No, even yourself will be rotating around. If you go to some other planet and if you observe the earth, you know, earth will not be at rest. It will be having its own spinning motion. Means what? It will be having its own rotation with respect to the axis. It is continuously rotating like this. And somewhere you are standing on the earth, now I am standing here, right? So will I be at rest if I go and see somewhere on moon or some other planet, if I go and see, right? So will I be at rest? No, I won't be. But with respect to the earth, with respect to the room, I am at rest itself. But that's what, the frame of reference, if I take it as earth, I am at rest. But the frame of reference, I will take it as moon, for my position, I am not at rest. I will be rotating. Means I am changing my position from one point to other point on the globe. You know, with respect to what? With respect to earth, if I take. So that means, with respect to what you are going to make the measurements is what? Frame of reference, what you have to remember with. Remember this terminology, ma? Frame of reference. Frame of reference. Frame of reference is with respect to what actually the measurements are going to be made. Is it to be what? A frame of reference. Okay. So with respect to different types or different frames of reference, you know, measurements are going to be varied. That's what we have to study with. Now, you'll see the basic definition for rest now. What exactly the rest is? When you'll say the body is said to be at rest, when it is not moving, it is said to be at rest. Is it correct statement? In your lower standards, you might have studied. When the body is not moving at all, then we'll say that it is at rest. But you need to add some perfect definition for that. So what that perfect definition is? The body is said to be at rest if it doesn't change its position, no doubt. With respect to what? With respect to time and with respect to surroundings. With respect to surroundings, right? Surroundings I am speaking here, what exactly it is? I am taking earth as a reference, right? Then with respect to these surroundings, I am not changing my position. That's why with respect to this earth, I will be at rest. If I go to moon and if I say, I will be at rest, means it will go wrong. That's why when you are speaking something about rest in the sense, no doubt if a body doesn't change its position with respect to time and with respect to its surroundings, then we will say that the body will be at rest. Keep this point in mind. Doesn't change its position, does not change its position with respect to time and surroundings. This is major factor, with respect to time and surroundings. If I keep a duster, for example, somewhere at this point, you know, I am going to keep a duster here on a desk. If I am going to keep a duster, it doesn't change its position. If you come tomorrow, it will be there itself, means with respect to time, right? With respect to surroundings, it will be there itself. But if you take with respect to moon, will it be at rest? So that's what the coordinate system are, with respect to what a reference frame we are taking. That is very important when you are going to make certain measurements. Whenever you are making the measurements, with respect to what you are going to measure is very important, which you have to remember with. So now this is about the rest. And next, now the body is not at rest. When the body will not be at rest? When it will not be at rest? If it changes its position, either with respect to time or surroundings, then we will say that the body will no more will be at rest. The body will not be at rest means what? It's not at rest means it will be in motion. If it is in motion. So motion means if continuously the body is going to change its position from one place to other place or from one position to other position, if it keeps on changing its position with respect to time, then we will say that the body is in motion. Okay. So now talking about this point, let's say initially at 0 meter mark it is, and this is 1 meter mark, and this is 2 meter mark, 3 meter mark, and this is 4 meter mark, and so on. Let me say there is one reference frame. I have taken this one as one reference frame. Now the particle initially at origin or 0 meter mark, now it has been moved, it's or changed its position to 3 meter mark. It has been traveled till where? 3 meter mark. Can you say that at 2 meters the body is at rest here? No. Why? Because it is moving away. It just moves from one position to other position. That's what motion is. It is a straight line motion here. It is changing its position from one place to other place. It's not like it has to travel from in this direction itself. If it has traveled like this, even it has been moved from this point A to B itself. From A to B itself, the particle has been moved. The particle has been moved from A to B, right? So changed its position irrespective of straight line it is moving, or in a plane or in space. If it changes its position with respect to time, then we will say that the body is said to be under motion. Okay. So now here itself I will come back for one more point here. So what is that? If it starts from here and ends over here, see carefully all of you. If it starts at A and ends over at A, this is the actual path in which it has traveled. While moving from A to B, it met one more point C and it reached B here. And it can travel directly from A to B in this straight line path also. Two possibilities we are having. When I speak about a position of the body has been changed from A to B, there are two possibilities in this particular picture what I have represented. What are the two possibilities here? The particle can move in the straight line path from A to B directly, or the particle can move in this path ACB. While moving from position A to B, it can meet a point C and it has traveled. So you can observe two points over here. This is the shortest distance what it has traveled from one position to other position, and this is actual path length. See, this is what the path of the particle in which it has traveled. Actually it has met C, and let's say it is going to reach the point B, means it has traveled in this path, means this is the actual path in which the particle has traveled. So that's why this length of this path is actually whatever it has traveled, we should call it as distance or path length. Distance or path length. What exactly the distance or path length is? It is actual path, or the total length of the path in which the particle has traveled. Length of the path in which the particle has traveled is called distance. Total length of the path. Length of the path in which the particle has traveled from one position to other position, that we used to call it as what? Path length or distance. Both are on the same. Distance or path length is what? Actual path length, what it has traveled from one point to other point. We used to call it as what? Distance. Remember this point. And immediately I need to come across one more point. What do you call that as? Displacement. So what exactly the displacement is? Displacement. Displacement is the shortest straight line distance between initial and final positions. So this is very important. Unlike the distance traveled, displacement whenever you are going to mention, actual path length is distance. This is what it has been. Now, what is the initial position here? A. And what is the final position here? B. Particle has started from position A and ended over at the position B. This is the final position and this is the initial position. In between final and the initial position, right? So, what is the straight line path it has traveled? Displacement is the shortest distance. Keep this point in mind. Shortest straight line distance between initial and final positions. Shortest straight line distance. Straight line distance. I'm calling here a distance once again. Straight line distance. How it should be shortest, right? So that itself we used to call it as displacement. Between what? Initial and final positions. Between initial and final positions. Between initial and final positions. And final positions we used to call it as what? Displacements. So I'm writing the definitions even. In the beginning sessions, it is important for you to remember with these definitions even. So I'm writing you for a certain time. Later in the material, you can come across all these definitions again. Material in the sense, whatever the written material or like printed material, what we are going to supposed to give, right? In that you can find all the definitions again. Nothing to bother, but try to understand the concept what exactly it is. So now, shortest straight line distance between what? Initial and the final positions. You need to look for only initial position and final position when you are talking something about the displacement. You need not to bother about in which path the particle has traveled. It may travel from C, or it may travel in somewhere, it may meet some point D even, or however it is going to move, or if it travels in the straight line path itself, whatever it is, you have to bother only about the final position and initial position when you are talking something about displacement. So we will see some examples for them, what exactly the distance is and what exactly the displacement is. Examples for distance and displacement if I speak. Okay. So, displacement I told, initial and final positions. Same coordinate system I will take like this 0 meter mark, 1 meter, 2 meter, 3, 4 and so on. Okay. I will mark 3 points over here. This is A, B, C and some D, let me say. Or instead of this, I will take this is B, and this is some position C, and let us say this is minus 1 meter mark. It is to the left of the coordinate system, you are all aware. It is minus 1 meter, 0. Initially, let us say the position of the particle is at 1 meter mark, at x equals to 1 meter, the position of the particle is. It is residing at 1 meter initially. So now, this position, let's say this point is P, initial position is P. It has been moved from P to C, let me say. From where to where it has been moved? From P to C. Can you tell me, if it has been moved from P to C, what will be the displacement of the particle here? Displacement when it has been moved from P to C. Told you, shortest distance between initial and the final positions in the straight line path. How to find out the displacement means, final position, 4 minus initial position is what? 1. 4 minus 1. How much it is? 3 meters will be the displacement here. Keep this point in mind. 4 minus 1. How much it is? 3 meters. Means if a particle starts from the position of x1 and if it has been moved to a position of x2 irrespective of its path, then the displacement of that particular particle in that straight line, it is going to be written as x2 minus x1. This is the displacement. See, I am not mentioning about the concept of vector initially. That part of the direction, see what exactly the vector is, not to represent that. Again, certain conditions to be redefined. So, I am going to come back to the concept of differentiation with, differing with scalar and a vector concept. I will just come back with that. Before that, you just have an idea of what exactly the displacement is, change in the position, how we need to find out. Final position minus initial position. So, in that term only, you just speak out. You can take it as a numerical exactly. So, likewise, after learning with a concept, immediately you have to follow with a numerical over there. So, that that makes you to understand the concept as well as solving the problem also, it is going to be easier. So, now I will say the particle has started from point P and it has reached some point C, I told, from P to C. What is the displacement? It has been now 4 minus 1. How much it will be? 3 meters. So, now again, from C it has been moved to point A, let me say. From where to where it is moving now? From C to A. From C to A, if the particle is moving, what will be the displacement of the particle if I mention? What is the initial position here? C. And final position is what? A. At C, what is the position you are having here? 4 meter. Initial position is what? 4 meter. And final position is what? 0 meter. I told you, final position minus initial position you have to take. Irrespective of what exactly the path it is traveling, it may be traveled from here to here. We are not bothered about it. But final position is what? A. What is that? 0 meter mark. And initial position is what? 4 meter. Okay. So, that means 0 final position, displacement will be equals to final position is 0 minus initial position is what? 4. That means it is minus 4 meters. Keep this point in mind. The sign is very, very important. That's what I have mentioned. So, if I want to speak in terms of a vector, directions are to be considered. I have not yet made into a vector what exactly it is. I'll have a small introduction of that part also, or if you are aware of that what exactly the vector is, then it will be easier and convenient for you to carry this forward further. Okay. So, now final position is what? 0 and initial position is 4 meter. That's what? Minus 4 meter. When you talk something about its distance traveled, instead of displacement, this is displacement I am speaking. If I say what is the distance it has traveled means, let's say it has traveled from C to A in straight line path itself, then how much is the distance it has traveled from this 4 meter mark to 0 meter mark means 4 meters. If you say distance, you have to write 4 meters itself directly. Distance equals to what? 4 meters in case of what? A particle traveled from C to A. If the particle has been traveled from C to A, distance is 4 meter. But when you are going to represent the displacement, minus 4 meter. This negative sign also it is very important here. You have to represent even the negative sign when you are talking something about what? Displacement. This is displacement. With respect to position itself, I am saying vector notation when you take, then it will be easier and convenient for you to represent the directions even what exactly it is. So, like if it is moving along x direction, we'll talk something about if it is moving in x direction, I cap, this is the direction to represent for a particle moving in x direction. If the particle is moving in y direction, j cap which to represent. This is the unit vector which to say. That's what. If I speak something about the vectors now, I need to go in depth about the vectors and are the points related to that, but definitely here itself two more terminology will get. What is that? Velocity and acceleration. So, even for velocity and acceleration representation, right? So, vector notations are required. So, there is a need for representing or talking something about the vector here itself. I will mention that, but after certain time or after following certain classes, we will have. Definitely, I am going to mention what is a vector and representation of a vector, how we have to represent. In general, they are being classified into two types, scalars and vectors, physical quantities. So, there are a few differences between scalars and vectors. What basic differences are required, we will study. But when you move to the motion in a plane, 100% we need to be thorough with the vectors. After learning with the concept of vectors only, we are going to have the discussion on motion in a plane. I told you, right, if it is moving in, starting from origin, it has been moved to some point x, y, if I say, right? So, then in that particular course of discussion, definitely we are in need of vectors. So, after even in your part of the text, what you are having, motion is plane, when you are studying, first introduction of vectors, applications related to all the vectors. After studying that only we are going to study about the motion plane topic. So there you won't find any difficulty. But as of here, when you represent, I'll just give a small point to represent over there, how to represent for vector notation, what exactly it is. After this particular point, I'm going to mention a small difference and we'll see that. So now, when you talk something about the distance and displacement, you know, this is how we need to find out if it is moving in a straight line path. See, now even like, let me say the particle has started from origin. See, carefully all of you. Started from origin, it reached point A, and again from point A, or let's say this is point A, you know, it reached point C, let me say. Again from point C, the particle has moved its position to P, let me say. See this path what it has traveled now. From O to C, O to C it has been moved. Again from C, where it has come, again it has traveled back to what? P. O to C and C to P. O to C and C to P. So now what is the displacement traveled and distance traveled, they'll ask. How to find out the distance and displacement in this case now? What is the case I am considering now? The particle is traveling from O to C and then again from C to P. O to C and C to P. O to C means this position and C to P is a, this is the initial position for us now. This is the initial position and this will be the final position. Keep this point in mind. Positions are required when you are talking something about the displacement and the path is required when you are talking about the distance. Two points you have to remember. So I told you, when you are finding out the displacement, what you have to make? Final position minus initial position, I told you. What is the final position here? 1 meter. 1 meter is final position minus, what is the initial position here? 0. That's why 1 minus 0. How much it is? 1 meter will be the displacement. You talk something about the distance travelled. How much is the total distance it has travelled now? Let me say, it has travelled in straight line path itself. It has travelled from O to C. How much distance it has travelled from O to C here now? 4 meters. And it made its travel back, transition back to from where to where? C to P again. Means how much it has travelled again? From 4 to 1 meter means it will be 3 meters. 1 plus 1 plus 1. It will be 3 plus 4 total. So it has travelled a distance if I speak, right? Distance if I speak, it will be 4 plus 3. It will be equals to what? 7 meters. Distance travelled is 7 meters. But displacement is how much? 1 meter. A very basic very basic thing what you need to understand for what exactly the distance and displacement. And remember, I am not mentioned anything still about the direction of the displacement. I will just come in the further classes or in the coming sessions, you know, we'll have a small point related to that even. Even like, see, again, starting from A, see this point now. Starting from A, particle has been moved to point C and it has come, made the transition back from C to, let's say it is some D, let me say. O to C and C to D it has come now. O to C, again from C to D the particle has travelled even. So now you just think of what are the initial and final positions. Initial position is O, no doubt. And what is the final position now here? It's not ended up at P. It just made its motion till where? Till D. Means what? This is the final position. This is what? The final position of the particle. Initial position is what? 0 meter mark. Final position is what? Minus 1 meter. So what is the displacement now I need to talk about? Displacement is, final position is minus 1 minus initial position is 0. Minus 1 minus 0. So means how much it will be now? Minus 1 meter. These are all like combination of different problems what you have to remember. These are all very basics as you have come from schooling, right? So this is, this helps you in understanding what exactly these basic definitions are. In depth about the points how they are going to ask also we will see. Here I will give one more point, you just represent now. Simple things I mentioned here. Now let me say, initial position of the particle is, initial position of the particle is not at origin now. It is at some 2 meter mark, let me say. This is the initial position. Where the particle is starting from? 2 meter mark. That means from B is the initial position of the particle. It has travelled over C. B to C it has travelled. From where to where? B to C. Again from C to D it has travelled. This point what we have considered as D. B to C it has travelled. Again from C to where? D. Now I just want B to C, from where? B to C and from C to D it has travelled. This is the total path in which it has travelled. I want what is the displacement here now. What is the value of displacement at this point? what exactly the displacement is. I told you when you are talking something about displacement, have to look only for final position and initial position. What is final position here? Minus 1 meter mark is final position. This is final position. What is initial position here? 2 meter mark. What is final? Final position is what? Minus 1. Minus initial position is what? 2 meter. This is 2 meter. What is the displacement of the particle now? Minus 3 meter is the displacement. Keep this. How much it is? Minus 3 meter is what? Displacement of the particle. Negative sign also do valid here in case of displacement when you are speaking. At the same time, what is the distance travel? Can you tell me now? B to C means how much it is? 4 minus 2 means how much it is? This is 2 meters. And from here to here means up to here is 4 plus 1. How much? 5. So totally distance travel will be equals to, in this case, distance travel will be equals to how much? This is 2 plus, this will be 5. From here to here is 5. So how much it is totally? 7 meters is a displacement travel. This is about displacement, how we need to find out, and distance, how we need to find out on a single coordinate system what we are having with. So now we will have discussion related to the same in the other way. Just a minute. So I'll give one more example for the same now. So like in other way I'll give it, see. Okay. So now I'll say an athlete is running in a circular track. Of radius r, let me see, this is the radius. It's just moving in a circular path like this. Okay. So he started from this position A. Keep this point in. He started from position A and he has made half a rotation or semicircle. He completed till here now. From where to where he has traveled? A to B. When he has traveled from A to B, when he has completed half the rotation, the last question, what is the distance traveled? Here, what is the value of distance and what is the value of displacement? Distance and displacement. Only magnitudes, if you mention, it is enough. So, what is this? Let's say it is of 2 meter radius. What is the radius of this circular track we are having? 2 meters. Radius is 2 meters. R equals to 2 meters, they are given. What is the distance he has traveled by the time when he has completed half the rotation? What is the distance traveled? I mean, this is the path, this is the actual path, right? See, the total distance means what? Circumference. Well, if he completes one rotation, circumference will be equals to how much? Circumference will be equals to 2 pi r. One complete rotation means how much is the distance traveled? 2 pi r. Half the rotation means what? By 2 is what? The distance traveled. Distance traveled will be equals to what? Circumference by 2. How much it is? 2 pi r by 2. Substitute for the values. 2 into pi value is 3.14 into. Radius is how much? 2 meters divided by 2. It will be 6.28 meters you will get. Cancel. And 6.28 meters is what? Distance traveled. How about the displacement now? Displacement means started from here and ended up here. This is the shortest path, right? This is what displacement now. Final position minus initial position. How much is, if you take this point as 0, this point will be how much now? 4. Or you can say displacement will be equals to what? 2r. Displacement equals to 2r, right? How much it is? 2 into 2. That is 4 meters is what? Displacement. Displacement equals to 4 meters. Distance equals to how much? 6.28 meters. In basic example. See, in the same example, I'll just ask like, see, this understood, right? This is for half the rotation, how to find distance and displacement. Very basics. Instead of completing the circular path, you know, the particle or this person has traveled only from quarter portion of the circle he has traveled, let me say. How much is the distance he has traveled now? Quarter portion of the circle. Only from here to here he has traveled. You see? The center, let's say, has traveled from A to B. Traveled from A to A, only quarter portion of the circle he traveled. Quarter portion of the circle from A to A has traveled, A to B. How much is the distance traveled in this case? And what is the displacement over here? They'll ask for it. So how to find out the distance? No doubt path in which it has traveled. In this path what he has traveled, distance traveled is how much, can you tell me? This is what R, this will be the radius R even. This is the path in which it has traveled, right? How much is this distance now? This is one quarter of the total circumference. Means distance traveled is one quarter, means one fourth of the circumference. One fourth means what? Circumference is how much? 2 pi r divided by, one fourth of it means divided by 4. So means distance now it will be equals to 2 pi r divided by 4 is how much? 2 pi r divided by 4. 2 ones, 2 twos, radius is also 2 meters. That's why r and 2 they'll get cancelled. So finally pi equals how much? 3.14 meters. Distance traveled here is 3.14 meters. When you talk about the displacement, from A to B the displacement, this is the final and initial. This is the shortest straight line path, right? Straight line path from A to B is what? This one. Is moved from initial to final position. From A to where? A to B. What will be the displacement? This is R and this is R. Using Pythagoras theorem, you are aware. Right triangle it is. Then AB square will be equals to how much now? AB square equals to R square plus R square, or AB equals to what? Root of 2 R square, or R root 2 it is. How much it is? R into root 2. R into root 2 is what? Displacement. R how much is given? 2 meters. That's why 2 root 2 is what? Displacement. 2 into root 2 value is 1.414. You can substitute. You will get the value of what? Displacement in this condition. Distance and displacement. Keep this point in mind. Now, in the same problem, I'll ask one more. You just have to think of now. Here the particle has completed one complete rotation. One complete rotation if it has been made, for example. I'll say it has completed one rotation. Started from here, you know, this radius. Started from A, it has completed one rotation. Completed one rotation means distance traveled is, no doubt, distance will be equals to how much? Distance will be equals to 2 pi r. There is no doubt in that. How about displacement now? This is important. Displacement equals to how much? How much is the displacement? How to find? Displacement will be equals to initial position and final position, both are same. Displacement I told you, change in the position, final position minus initial position. Initial position is A, final position is also A, that's why displacement will be equals to how much? Zero here. If a body completes one complete rotation, displacement will be zero. If it completes one rotation, distance will be 2 pi r. So now if I say body completes two rotations, how many rotations it made? Two rotations, then distance traveled will be 2 pi r into 2. Displacement will be how much? Once again, after two rotations also it is coming back to the same initial position. That's why its displacement is zero. Got it? Distance and displacement. Okay? So this is one very important thing which you have. If I say 1.5 rotation it has made. 1.5 means one complete rotation, further half rotation it made. Now tell me about distance now. How much is the distance traveled? Here distance traveled will be equal to how much? 1.5 rotation means what? 2 pi r for one rotation, again pi r for half the rotation. So totally 2 pi r plus pi r equals how much? 3 pi r is the distance traveled, and displacement is how much? Finally, after one rotation it is here, after one more half a rotation in the particle is at this point. That's why displacement is how much now? 2 r. Displacement will be equals to 2 r. So like this the problems related to distance and displacement. I hope you got some idea related to the distance and displacement. I am talking only about the magnitudes. I am not bothered about the direction for displacement in all the cases what you have studied. And one more best example I will take. One more best example I will take. See here. There is a wheel. Let me say. This is what a wheel is. Initially, this what a point which I will take on the wheel, which is at the point of contact. You know, a wheel if I am going to place over on the surface, right? This is the position initially, a wheel small point I have taken. Now, wheel has been moved 1/4 of the rotation it made, for example, means this position of the particle will come to which position now? This position? It has come to this position now. Earlier the position of the point which I have taken on the wheel is at the point of contact. Wheel has been rolled. It has been rolled so that this point will be here now. What is the displacement of the particle they lost? It is very crucial. Little bit higher level. Till now all basics we have seen. Little bit more. How to find this displacement now? Displacement means I told you this is the final position. This is the initial position. Shortest distance between these two. This what which you have to find it out. How to find the distance? See, from P to this point of contact to point of, how much distance it has rolled, how much distance it, 1/4 it has rolled means this distance, yes, it will be equals to, how much is this distance? Distance of this part will be equals to 1/4 of the rotation. 1/4 of the rotation means, I told you already, 2 pi r divided by 4. See carefully. Distance it has traveled is 1/4 from here to here. The point has been moved from here to here. Means it has rolled like this, you can imagine, that's what imagination is required. It has rolled here, the position has come here, means it has rolled a distance of how much here now? 2 pi r by 4. 2 pi r by 4, this length is how much? See, I want only this particular displacement. No doubt distance traveled is 2 pi r by 4 means pi r by 2, I can say, there is no doubt in that. When you talk something about the displacement, only this part I have to say. Displacement when you are talking, no doubt, this length is how much? This is r radius. Why? Because the same length we are going to have from center, right? This is r. And I want this length now. Why? Because hypotenuse, you can, this s will be the hypotenuse, so that from right triangle you can apply Pythagoras theorem and you can solve for s. I will say it is some x. What is the value of x here now? And can you tell me this length is how much here? This length is r radius. Why? Because up to here what you are having the distance from point of contact to the surface, you know, this is nothing but r. So what is the value of x then? Finally, x will be equals to this total distance s minus r. How much is the total distance you got? Pi r by 2. R is ma pi r by 2 minus r. So now if you want to solve for displacement, s will be equals to here also s we have taken, I will say it is some d something. D it will be equals to root of x square plus r square is what displacement here. What is the value of x? We got pi r by 2 minus r. Root of this is pi r by 2 minus r whole square plus r square. This is what displacement if the particle moves from or if a rolling body has been moved 1/4 of that, right? Displacement of the particle as on the wheel has been moved a distance of displacement of how much? Root of pi r by 2 minus r whole square plus r square. Instead of that, I'll give one more example before winding up the session, right? If it has been moved for half the rotation, let me say, if the particle is here, half the rotation if it has been moved, then what is the displacement if you want to find? How to find out? You can take it as a work otherwise. So that I'll discuss about the same point in the next session at least. Okay? Fine. So I'll wind up for today. I hope you got the points related to the distance and displacement, and remaining we'll see them in the next session. See the next example when we start with the next section, right? We are going to have the discussion like when it has completed half the rotation, what is the displacement we have to find out. We'll stop here. We'll see the remaining in the next session.